June 5th, 1967. Israel launches a large-scale surprise attack on Egypt, Jordan, and Syria in a preemptive military strike to counter an impending attack by Arab nations surrounding Israel. The war lasted just 6 days, ending in a decisive victory for Israel in both military strength and land acquisition. Israel emerged the premier military power in the region, but the defeat was a crushing blow to the Arab nations, who lost morale in critical territories, including areas of great strategic value such as the Sinai Peninsula, the Golan Heights, and the West Bank of the Jordan River. Additionally, more than 600,000 Arabs lived in the West Bank at the time, and now under Israeli occupation, many young Arabs who felt displaced and unrepresented began joining the Palestinian Liberation Organization, a group Israel deemed a terrorist organization. In the end, the Six-Day War marks another chapter of failed diplomacy and the long-running conflict between the State of Israel and its Arab neighbors. In order to fully understand the events leading up to the Six-Day War, we need to look back in history, beginning with the Zionist movement and their desire to create a Jewish state.
Modern Zionism started in Europe, mostly in the 1800s, which was a time of a lot of growing nationalist movements across Europe, and the European Jews also sort of around this issue, some in response to incidents of anti-Semitism and some just, I think, in the general atmosphere of growing nationalism, decided that it was time for them to also have a state.
In Eastern Europe, in Russia and Poland, there are attacks against Jews. The government, in some cases, encourages increasing pressure on Jews. At one point, Russia wants to force conversion or force Jews to leave or have Jews killed.
The rise of Nazism during the Second World War created a mass exodus of Jews, leaving Europe and trying to enter Palestine. Between 1939 and 1945, an estimated 72% of all Jews in Nazi-occupied Europe were murdered. Survivors of the Holocaust wanted to settle in Palestine, then under British mandate.
There are differing opinions about what role the Holocaust played in the creation of Israel. Some would say that it was the pivotal moment that led the Jews to believe that they would never be safe without a homeland and led the world to have this collective sense of guilt that made them vote in favor of a Jewish state. And others would argue that it was an inevitable process that was going to happen anyway, even if the Holocaust may have sped it up. No one would say it's disconnected, but the degree of importance would vary depending on who you ask.
Following the Second World War, the United Nations General Assembly approved a plan that created two states in Palestine, one Jewish and one Arab, in an effort to end conflict in the region. The United Nations two-state solution was met with overwhelming joy in the Jewish community and discontent among Arabs who rejected the resolution. The opposition ignited conflict between Arabs and Jews, and eventually, the 1948 War of Independence began.
The 1948 had been building for several years. As World War II got underway, more and more Jews were coming, both legally and illegally, to Palestine. The British had limited the number of Jews who were allowed in each year, and there was constant tension between arrival of Jewish immigrants with the native Arab population, and there were several incidents of riots and violence that came along with different waves of Jewish immigration. The UN partition plan was to create two states, a Jewish state and a Palestinian state, in what was British Mandate Palestine. The UN voted on it. It was accepted by a majority, and the British agreed that they would leave the British Mandate of Palestine in 1948. So leading up to that, there were beginnings of attacks and sort of a low-grade war between the Jews who were already in Palestine and the Arabs who were in Palestine and in the neighboring countries. And when the British withdrew in May 1948 and David Ben-Gurion, the to-be prime minister of the new state of Israel, declared independence, it broke out into a larger war.
The Arab states in 1948 are not really independent, but they're obsessed with the idea of more European control. And while for the future Israelis, they see themselves as coming back to a place, from the point of view of the Arabs and the Arab states, this is just more Europeans coming into the region and making plans for it. So they see Israel as a little fragment of European imperialism. That's why they're so determinedly opposed to it. It's already a war zone before 1948. The UN partition effort is an international effort to say, look, can we divide this place up? And war is already beginning. So the war in 1948 was certainly a war people could see coming. It was not a surprise.
The 1956 Suez Canal crisis planted seeds of further discontent and set the stage for the Six-Day War.
The Six-Day War in 1967 had probably been building for a while, probably since 1948 and prior. In 1956, there was another outbreak of violence after Egypt decided to nationalize the Suez Canal, which upset Israel and as well as some of the European countries, Britain and France, who wanted access to the Suez Canal because it was an important waterway for trade. Israel and Britain and France took over the Sinai Peninsula in an effort to stop Egypt. They pushed back and they ended up withdrawing, but that just sort of added to the tensions in the region between different powers. So in 1967, Egypt then also blocked the Straits of Tehran, which were another important waterway for passage and trade. And there was increased violence between the Jews and Arabs inside and between Israel and the West Bank. And at some point, Israel decided they needed to act, and they made a preemptive strike on the Egyptian Air Force. The Egyptians were unprepared for this. All their planes were sitting on the ground quietly, and Israel was able to successfully destroy the whole Air Force, which gave them certainly a leg up in the war and then also precipitated the start of the full-blown war.
Behind the scenes, the Soviets and the U.S. were putting heavy pressure on the Arabs and Israelis to agree to a ceasefire before the conflict got out of hand and they had to step in. In the end, Israel won in a decisive victory and demonstrated it was capable of initiating successful military strategic strikes that could change the balance of the power in the region.
The 1967 Six-Day War was definitely a pivotal moment in reshaping the landscape of the Middle East. You could definitely argue that a lot of the wars and conflicts and violence that has happened since then would have happened regardless, but it certainly changed the power dynamics between Israel and the Arab countries, and also between the way the world viewed the Middle East and the Middle East viewed the world. It changed sort of the playing field in that Israel now felt that they had these bargaining chips, that they could or could not give back these pieces of land in exchange for getting things from their Arab neighbors, which prior to the 1967 war, they didn't have as much clout. They didn't have that much to offer. It also changed the relationship of how the world saw Israel, whether or not they saw it as an occupying power. A lot of the world accepted the 1948 war and its outcome and the independence of the State of Israel as a legitimate nation-state claim, even though some would argue that they still came in and occupied the lands of Palestinians, but most of the world accepted that that was what happened. Whereas after 1967, Israel was occupying a much larger portion of land, most of which they did not even officially annex. They did not offer citizenship to the people who were living there. And so that created a very deep source of tension between Israel and the people that were living in the lands in the West Bank and in Gaza and in the Sinai Peninsula, as well as the Golan Heights in East Jerusalem, and really set the stage for a lot of the conflict that happened afterwards.
In the end, Israel failed to get Arab nations to recognize Israel and to successfully negotiate peace treaties with its neighbors. Until peace treaties are accomplished with all its Arab neighbors, then tension and unrest will continue to exist between Israel and the Arab states.